out of the treasure trove of intelligence taken from this compound, three wives of Osama bin Laden, and CNN has now confirmed their identities with a U.S. official.
One of them is Amal al-Sadah, who married bin Laden in 2000. Officials believe this passport photo found at the compound is her. She had a daughter with bin Laden, Safia, who was born shortly after 9/11. And Safia's told Pakistani officials she saw her father being shot. Amal al-Sadah is Yemeni and is bin Laden's youngest wife.
An old cowpoke went riding out one dark and windy day. Upon a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw, a-plowing through the ragged skies and up a cloudy draw. The ghost herd in the sky. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny and their hot red he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the sky, for he saw the riders coming hard.
I'll repeat it again. And he heard the CIA did not charge bin Laden with attacking the World Trade Center. The FBI did not charge bin Laden with attacking the World Trade Center. NATO did not charge bin Laden with attacking the World Trade Center. It is what it is. What it really is, it's just a code to move on to the next phase. See, because this boogeyman is gone, we don't need him anymore. Now we're gonna move on to something else. Because see, Al-Qaeda said, whoa, we might nuke a city if you kill, you know, our main man, which never existed. So because you killed Osama bin Laden, well, now we're going to have to hit you. So now we've already set the stage for the next thing to happen. You know, go back and look at World War II. They always referred to it as the Pacific Theater and the European Theater. Do you know why? Because it's all a play. It's staged.
I don't play fantasy football. I play for real football. It takes a lot of hard work. A pinch of luck, body muscles, some salt, and this, Old Spice Swagger Body Wash.
It's like a fantasy, only it's real.
So I'm going to go over this one more time so that you understand. The man Bin Laden never existed. They have been working on certain types of weaponry based on quantum physics, which is also known in the old world as Kabbalah. It's the same thing. One's Kabbalah, which is based on magic. The other one is quantum physics, which is based on science. Magic is nothing but science that hasn't been revealed or explained. The towers were knocked down either intentionally or by mistake because they are messing with quantum physics, okay? Now, you can't knock down two towers and just expect everybody to go, oh, nothing to see here, move along. So they had to assign a name to it. So they came up with the name Bin Laden or Bin Laden. What holds this planet together, the electromagnetics, the electrical system, space, time, gravity, is the planet Saturn. Okay? The mystics all know this. That's why it's the main focal point of all the religions, and people don't realize it. That's why you have the hexagon on the Hebrew flag, because it's a cube. It represents Saturn. It's sitting in the UN prayer room. Go Google UN meditation room, and you'll see a black cube sitting in there. It represents Saturn. Look at Mecca. There's a black cube there. It represents Saturn. The cube, the square that you wear on your head, represents Saturn. Because to these people, it is God, and it is a very big part of the reality of which we live in. It's not God. It's part of the creation. But that's what it does. It regulates time and space. So they, in Hebrew, they call Saturn, it has many names, but one of them is Bina, B-I-N-A-H. So they shorten the word to Bin, B-I-N. Okay? And then they added Laden. Laden, L-A-D-E-N. Laden means like heavy weight to tie down, restrain, or hold back. Now you have Bin Laden. See? So now they assign that to the name of the mathematical problem or the quantum physical problem, and they called it Bin Laden. And so they told you Bin Laden did it. In other words, it didn't work out like we said. It was Bin Laden that did it. You see? So now they've got a boogeyman that they can chase after. So now they say he's hiding in caves. The cave that Bin Laden was in, which is just, it's theoretical, is what's called Plato's cave. And what that means is Plato said, look, if you took people and you chained them to a wall and you had a fire and the only thing that they never saw outside, they just saw shadows on the wall, that's all that they would ever understand as reality. They would never know that if they looked over this way, that they would see the true reality of what's outside of that cave. And so what they're saying is that you have been so well trained in your head to believe what you see that you believed what you saw, not the reality of it. And that's not your fault. This is so high tech crap, you can't believe it. And so the commercial I did with the Raven, okay, the Raven has always been known as the messenger of Saturn. That's why Edgar Allan Poe and the Raven, Nevermore, it represents Saturn, it represents death. Okay, so the Grim Reaper, which also represents Saturn, why does he carry a sickle? Because people say, well, it means death. No, it doesn't. It means sickle because it's a cyclical, spelled with a C, meaning cycles. Goes round and round. Life, death, beginning, end, start, finish. Okay, the book in the Bible, Ecclesiastes, a time to laugh, a time to cry, a time to live, a time to die. It's all based on the planet Saturn and its phases. Okay? So these guys are messing around with quantum physics and they're screwing everything up in the world. And so that commercial where it showed the Raven with the football player on it flying to Saturn and blowing it up, is because they're trying to stop time. Now, why are they trying to stop time? Because there are those that have been here for a long, long time that understand that they can't keep messing with time. In other words, they're running out of it, okay? And so they pushed it back, and at least to my understanding, from what I've been able to pull together, 1973 was the last time, for lack of a better way to put it, they did a system restore, okay? Now they don't have a date to go back to. So you either, time is going to catch up with them, and they're going to be destroyed. This is where you get into the biblical, mythological crap. Or they're going to have to stop the program, okay? Which means that they get to survive indefinitely, okay? This has been going on for a long, long, long time. It's a very, very big, big story, okay? And so this is what CERN has been doing, okay? This is why it says in the book of Revelation in the Bible that Satan knows his time is short. Satan is synonymous with Saturn, but it doesn't mean that it's evil. It's just saying that the phase is coming to an end. The phase is coming to an end, and these guys know it, and they're panicking. They're doing everything that they can, okay, to stop time from catching up to them, okay? And so in Revelation it says, peace, peace, when you think you finally have peace, then catastrophe will come upon you and there will be no escape. That's, remember when they said that Bin Laden was killed? And whatever you say, oh, wonderful, joy, everybody celebrated. So let's go back to the day that Bin Laden got killed. Do you remember, if you go back and look at the video, this stealth helicopter they got, it's because it's quantum physics. They moved it point A to point B in time and space manipulation. That's why if you watch it, you'll see the woman going, I don't even know where this thing came from. I was just standing there and all of a sudden it appeared. Because they killed Bin Laden. They beat the time and space mathematical problem. And so they were all happy about it. And if you go watch the news footage, go Google stealth helicopter, Bin Laden's assassination, whatever, type that in, and you'll see it. And they made a real big deal about it. So this is what this is. See, this is a war of time and space. And that's why, I mean, I could go on and on and on, but there's no point in me going on until people understand and catch up to what I'm trying to tell you. And if you can't, it doesn't mean you're stupid. It's just some people ain't gonna get this. I mean, I failed pre-algebra. That shows you how smart I am when it comes to math. But I understand the esoteric of what's going on here. You know, I mean, it's. Well, I didn't actually fail pre-algebra. I got a D. Give me the credit on that. That's what they're dealing with. And so, when they said Bin Laden was hiding out in caves, they're using Plato's caves. In other words, they're saying, because all you've ever understood is what you've seen, that's all you'll ever know. See, they're making fun of you, basically, is what they're doing. That's what that whole, he's hiding in caves. No, the reality of it was hiding in caves because they never hipped people to what the truth is. And they sat back with their gin and tonics and laughing and smoking their cigars and collecting mass amounts of money and scaring the dog shit out of people. See, that's what's going on. That's why in that video I made, Truth is Stranger Than Fiction, where it shows that cube flying around, because that cube is time and space. That's what slammed into the towers and knocked them down. The one with the Donald Duck, remember that video? That cube? Okay, that cube represents Saturn. It represents time and space. Okay? They're scared. So, no more videos. We don't have to exchange any more bad words. Some people are gonna get this stuff, and some people won't. It's a fact. The ultimate weapon is time and space manipulation. And to put it in a more understandable way, let's say you're going to get in a fist fight with a guy, and you can go back before you get in a fist fight with a guy, and you're standing out of the way before he throws the punch. You can't combat that. Because now you're thinking you're punching him in the face, and you're getting punched in the back of the head. You see? It's the same thing. It's quantum physics, and it's what it is.